Hello, hello. Hello, hello, please, if you can listen up. You are most welcome to Blessed Sacrament Church. I need to remind you that this is a place of prayer and devotion. It's not a function room, so talking is not accepted unless you are talking to God. So if you need to talk to someone, please talk to God. And if you have an emergency that you need to talk with someone else, do it in a way that you won't disturb the atmosphere of prayer in church. Thank you very much. I will ask you also to put your mobile phone on silence or directly switch it off because it may disturb the celebration. And also remind you that confetti are not allowed in this area due to the proximity, the closeness with the traffic on the road and the wind. So if it happens, we may be fined and we'll send the fine to you. To the person, of course, because it's a danger to the public to throw confetti. So please refrain of doing that if you have planned to do that. Thank you very much. Please stand up to welcome the bride. May the Lord send your help from heaven. May protect you from his citadel on high. May he give you what your heart desire and strengthen you in all you undertake. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Please pray silently for the bride, Lyndsey, and the bridegroom, Adam. Father, you have made the bond of marriage a holy mystery, a symbol of Christ's love for his church. Hear our prayers for Lyndsey and Adam, with faith in you and in each other. They pledge their love today. May their lives always bear witnesses to the reality of that love. We ask this through Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Please take a seat. You are most welcome to Blessed Sacrament Church. I am Father Sergio. I am the parish priest. And I'm so happy to welcome you today in our church. Adam and Lyndsey have been great neighbors. They live next door. And I'm very happy, I'm very proud to be witness of their wedding, because they are the ministers in the sacrament of marriage. We are all witnesses. They are the one who will be ministers to their own love. And I want to welcome all of you with a warm heart, with a welcoming heart. You are all most welcome, and share the joy unhappiness and perhaps some nervous of Adam and Lyndsey, who come today to seal their lives in this altar, in this church. All of us are so happy. And the Word of God has a special place in our life. And today that we share the joy of their love, God has a special word for all of us. And the Word of God, the first reading, will be read by Kate Smith, the bridesmaid. Please come forward.
A reading from the Philippians. I want you to be happy, always happy in the Lord. I repeat, what I want is your happiness. Let your tolerance be evident to everyone. The Lord is very near. There is no need to worry, but if there is anything you need, pray for it, asking God for it with prayer and thanksgiving. And that peace of God that is so much greater that we can understand will guard your hearts and your thoughts in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers, fill your minds with everything that is noble, everything that is good and pure, everything that we love and honor, and everything that can be taught virtuous or worthy of praise. Keep doing all the things that you learn from me and have been taught by me and have heard or seen that I do. Then the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
We answer to the word of God, singing the hymn, All Things Bright and Beautiful.
Thank you. Please stand up for the gospel reading. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "This is my commandment. Love one another as I have loved you. A person can have no greater love than to lay down their life for their friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I shall not call you servants anymore, because a servant does not know their master's business. I call you friends, because I have made known to you everything I have learned from my Father. You did not choose me, no, I chose you, and I commissioned you to go out and to bear fruit, fruit that will last. And then the Father will give you anything you ask him in my name." The Gospel of the Lord. Please take a seat. Today, we are witnesses to the love that Adam and Lyndsey want to seal in front of God, the church, and this community. I explain to you, to them, what is a Catholic wedding, because a Catholic wedding is different from any other wedding. There's no divorce in the Catholic Church, because today they are sealing their love for a lifetime, and no one can break that bond. And the reason is because they are two and will become one, but not one, but three. Maths doesn't apply here. And I say three because you now can see Adam and Lyndsey, but there is a third person in question, that is God. This is a sacrament. And a sacrament is not our action. It's not Adam's action, Lyndsey's action, even though it needs their consent, but it's God's action. A sacrament is God's doing, is God's action. And what God unites today, no one can put asunder. This is a commitment for a lifelong term. They are both Catholics, and both of them agreed on these terms. It's God's action. No one can separate what God is uniting today. And this is a Catholic wedding. If we depend on our weaknesses, there's chance to have a split and go different ways. But as this is a sacrament, it's God's action. And no one can divide what God has united today. So, to understand what I am saying, I brought two things for this wedding. It's here. Let me find it. What? This is the first thing I brought. This is an empty bottle of Prada Loam, and this is an empty bottle of Calvin Klein Eternity. Nothing today with heaven, is eternity only. And as you can see, they are empty. Our Father is wanting us to buy another one for him. No, no, that's not what I want. I brought these to let you understand what kind of bond God is uniting today. And I ask you, what can I do with these bottles of empty aftershave? What can I do, Michael? Pardon? Well, Michael said recycle. You may say, bin it, it's empty. Well, that's the right answer. Recycle, bin it. Go to the streets, buy another one, and when you use it and you run out of it, wear it till it's empty, then bin it again and buy another one. That's what we do with the aftershave. Buy it, use it until it's empty, bin it when it's empty. Love is not a bottle of aftershave. Love is not like a bottle of aftershave. You cannot go to the street to find your love. You cannot buy love, even with all the money you have. You cannot use it. And you will never, ever run out of love. When you think that you don't feel anything for the person you consecrated your life, you cannot be in it and go to the street to find another love. That's what we do with a bottle of empty aftershave. We cannot do the same with the person we consecrated our love and our life. So you may say, well, what is love about? And this is the second thing I brought to Adam and Lyndsey wedding. Love is like this plant. It is meant to grow every day, to blossom and flourish. But this plant has four seasons. Now you, Lyndsey and Adam, you are in the spring of your love. You are all flourished like this plant. You can see all the flowers. But this plant will not be like this during the whole year, because there are four seasons. Perhaps this is the spring of this plant, as you are in the spring of your love. But it won't be like this all the time. Your love also will have four seasons. You are now in the spring and summer of your love, but winter and autumn will come. Be patient. It won't last long. This plant needs care, the right amount of water, the right amount of sunshine, the right temperature, not too much, not too little, just only the right. Your love also needs care. There are some people who have green fingers, and whatever he or she touches flourishes. I don't have green fingers, but some people do have green fingers and know what is good and what is bad for a plant. There are some tips to learn. I give you today three tips to keep your marriage life also flourishing and in summer. Because love is a decision Love is not a feeling. A feeling is something that we have and change all the time. Feeling like anger, fear, stress, emotion, happiness. It comes. We are so happy today. Then we receive a bad news and we are saddened. And something happened and we became angry or fearful. Emotions are so strong and changing all the time. Love is not a feeling. Love is a decision to make and continue to make every single day. The first piece of advice is this: never go to bed with a grudge in your heart. Speak to each other if you have bad feeling about your spouse. Speak. Never leave for the following day. Never go to bed at night if there is something you want to tell to your spouse. Never keep a grudge in your heart. The second piece of advice: when you wake up, say to her or him, "Today I will love you more than yesterday." Do it, mean it. This is my second piece of advice. And I leave the third for the end of the homily. And love is a decision. Many people do not see why a person would have to make the decision to love, since they have made that decision many years ago on their wedding day. The problem with feelings is that they are always changing. People are fickle. Feelings can be dangerous and can lead us astray, especially when it comes to relationship. Feelings change and are not easily controlled. Love is not a feeling. It is more than a feeling. Love is a decision. It's a decision to be open and to share when you don't feel like it. Love is a decision when you don't think your spouse deserves your love. Love is a decision to be open, honest when communicating with your spouse. And this does not only mean talking, but also listening. It means choosing to forgive when your spouse is remorseful and apologetic after hurting you. It can also mean not carrying a grudge and looking ahead instead of back. Making the decision to love includes the everyday. That's why I said never go to sleep with a grudge in your heart. Little things that you often do for one another, especially when you are not feeling loving, from your action of deciding to love, often the feeling of love will follow. But it also means, and this is the third piece of advice, it also means allowing yourself to be loved. And listen to this, Adam and Lyndsey. You cannot be the strongest all the time. It is about the choice to be vulnerable and put yourself out to let the other person in. You cannot be the strongest all the time because it's tiring. But you cannot be the weaker all the time because that's cheeky. The other person will see the good, the bad, your strength, your weaknesses, and so on. And that is not a problem, because we are made of dust. Adam, when you are saying today, "I do," to Lyndsey, you are not saying only "I do" to all the goodness that Lyndsey is. because all of us make in a packet, and in that packet you can find anything, good things, a little bit of evil, and you know that, you know that. And Lyndsey, when you say I do to Adam, you are saying I do, not only to the goodness, but the whole packet. So after living together for a while, you cannot say, I didn't know that you were like this. Yes, you knew, and you say, I do. And that is not a problem. And this is my third piece of advice. When you are saying I do now, you are saying I do to the whole person, to the whole packet, not only the goodness, but some kind of bad things that we are or we have, some attitudes that you don't like. You are saying, yes, I do, to the whole packet. That's why today you are saying, I do. For better and for worse, for richer and for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do you apart. That's what you are saying. And that is what I mean, the whole packet. You are not saying, yes, I love you to all the goodness that you are and have. No, you are saying, I love you to the whole person, and we are made of dust, for better, for worse. You are saying, well, I will love you when you have a big bank account of money in your wallet. No, you are saying for richer or for poorer. You are not saying I do when you are healthy, but if you are sick, well, I leave you alone. No, you are saying in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do you apart. That is a Catholic wedding. It's a wedding, it's a commitment in good times and in bad times, in times of love and in times of disagreement. And remember, when disagreement comes, because they will come, everyone knows that they will, you have a third person in between. God is in between, and God is the one who is making this love possible. Because the reading you chose is, love one another as I have loved you. And this is how God loved us, till the death on his cross, till the sacrifice of oneself for those who love. So be ready to sacrifice everything for the person you love. Well, if you are happy to do that, we continue. If you are not happy, there is a door there and another door there. That's all. But if you say, I do today, it's for your whole life. Till death do you apart. Are you happy with this? Remember the three pieces of advice? Yeah, I hope so. So, please, you two, stand up. Adam and Lyndsey, you have come together in this Church of the Blessed Sacrament, so that the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church minister and this community. Christ abundantly blesses this love. He has already consecrated you in baptism, and now he reaches and strengthens you by a special sacrament, so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so, in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Adam and Lyndsey, I shall now ask you if you freely undertake the obligations of marriage and to state that there is no legal impediment to your marriage. Adam and Lyndsey, are you ready, freely and without reservation, to give yourself to each other in marriage?
I am.
Are you ready to love and honor each other as man and wife for the rest of your lives? Are you ready to accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church? I think that they have already done that. Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, declare your consent before God and his church. Adam, John, Ian, Comstive, will you take Lyndsey Hulse here present for your lawful wife according to the right of our Holy Mother, the Church? Lyndsey Hulse, will you take Adam, John, Ian, Comstive here present for your lawful husband according to the right of our Holy Mother, the Church? Please, witnesses and the father of the bride, come forward. Face each other. You have declared your consent before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Blessing of the rings, I will ask the organist to play the Ave Maria. He's a witness as well. Are you? Very good. May the Lord bless these rings. No, no, wait. Which you give to each other as a sign of your love and fidelity.
It's very helpful. Good boy. You can be an altar server now. Please sit down. I will invite now a member of the family for the bidding prayers. Michael.
May all married people here be reminded of the joy of their old Wednesday. May they give thanks for all the happiness that they have known. May each day find them forever devoted to one another. Lord, hear us. Through his gift of sacrament of marriage, may God bless Adam and Lyndsey with happiness in their lives together. With patience and understanding, may they find strength in times of difficulty and seek comfort in each other. May the Lord help their love grow and bless their marriage with laughter and love. Lord, hear us. We pray for all the friends and family of Adam and Lyndsey and remember those who cannot be here today. We pray for them especially who have supported and helped them to this happy day. May God bless them with his gift of everlasting friendship. Lord, hear us.
Let commend ourselves and all God's people living and dead to Mary, the Mother of God and wife of Joseph the carpenter. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Now let us pray for Lyndsey and Adam in silence. The nuptial blessing. Please kneel for the nuptial blessing. Take the chairs out. Father, by your power, you have made everything out of nothing. In the beginning, you created the universe, and you made mankind in your own likeness. You gave man the constant help of a woman, so that man and woman should no longer be two, but one flesh. And you teach us that what you have united may never be divided. Look with love upon this woman, Lyndsey, your daughter, now joined to her husband, Adam, in marriage. She asks your blessing. Give her the grace of love and peace. May she always follow the example of the holy women whose praises are sung in the scriptures. May her husband, Adam, put his trust in her and recognize that she is his equal and the heir with him to the life of grace. May he always honor her and love her as Christ loves his bride, the church. Father, keep them always true to your commandments. Keep them faithful in marriage and let them be living examples of Christian life. Give them the strength which comes from the gospel, so that they may be witnesses of Christ to others. Bless them with children and help them to be good parents. May they live to see their children's children, and after a happy old age, grant them fullness of life with the saints in the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. As they are both Catholics, they will receive Holy Communion, only husband and wife. Let us pray with confidence to the Father in the words our Savior gave us. Please stand up. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. This is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lord. Lord, I'm not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Let us pray. Lord, we who have shared the food of your table, pray for our friends, Adam and Lyndsey, whom you have joined together in marriage. Keep them close to you always. May their love for one another proclaim to the world their faith in you. Through Christ our Lord. The final blessing. The Lord be with you. God the Father, keep you in love for each other, so that the peace of Christ may stay with you and be always in your home. Amen. May your children bless you, your friends console you, and all people live in peace with you. Amen. May you always bear witness to the love of God in the world, so that the afflicted and the needy will find in you generous friends and welcome you into the joys of heaven. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. We have finished the sacrament of marriage. They are now husband and wife, but we refrain from congratulating them now. We wait until they sign the register. Now there is the civil part of the wedding. Please, husband, take your wife to St. George's Chapel. Bridesmaid, witness, and best man, and the closest member of the family group and friends can go to St. George's Chapel if you want. and take a seat if you like, because it may take time. You can take a seat to be more comfortable if you like. Please stand up. Ladies and gentlemen, let me introduce you to Mr. and Mrs. Comstive. Congratulations and a happy marriage life. Congratulations and a happy marriage life. Remember the three pieces of advice. Okay. Now we say, we are so happy they are now husband and wife. And I know there have been many before, but this will be the first in front of the altar. Husband can kiss his wife. They were short. I think that they will continue later. Our recessional hymn.
Thank you.